That means Bitcoin's first bull run went from 7 cents to $27, about a 390x. Then it crashed all the way down to $2.14, and then went on for a second bull run. In its second bull run, it closes at over $1,100, but that actually peaks at over $1,200. That's over 560x on the second bull run, almost 50% larger than the first. So let's compare HEX to BTC. This blue line is BTC. That's the $27 top, down to the $214 low, and then up to the $1,200 high. HEX crushed it on the first bull run, and now we're coming into our own bear. HEX launched at a price of 0.02 of a cent, and went on to do a bull run from that to 52 cents. Like I said, completely crushing Bitcoin in its first cycle. That's a 2500x, but if Bitcoin did a larger run on its second cycle by about 50%, what is this gonna do? We're still in a bear market. The market can still go down. Let's say it loses another 50% from here and HEX drops down to 1.5 cents. But let's say it goes on to do a bigger bull run than its first bull run, just like Bitcoin did, since it already crushed Bitcoin in its first bull cycle. That's 3,750x. 3,750x times a 1.5 cent HEX price bottom. That puts us at over $50. Now, this ain't financial advice. I'm not saying that this is definitely what's going to happen, but I am saying, however, that this is just what S-curves do. S-curves don't start off parabolic. They go parabolic midway through. The first cycle is the early innovators. This is mass adoption. So just like these were the early adopters, so were these. If this is critical mass, so is this. So, if HEX does hit $50 in the next bull run, probably 2025, I'm not going to be surprised, because that's what it looks like.